So what are some possible issues that you could have with injection foam? Can it break your drywall? Can it cause electrical issues? Is it going to vibrate the walls? Well, yes, it can do all those things. Let's talk about it. So first, let's address drywall. Is there a chance that if you're putting injection foam in your existing walls, that it bows or cracks your drywall? Yes, it is certainly possible. Although with an experienced contractor, it should be very rare, there is always that chance. If your contractor is telling you that this never happens, it can't happen, they're simply not being honest. You gotta remember, you are putting foam, you're injecting this foam into an enclosed cavity, and you never really know how secure that drywall is. Did that drywaller even use screws? Is it just glued on? Are the studs not uniform? There are so many factors that go into this. So yes, it is absolutely a possibility, although it should be very rare. When it does happen, again, a good contractor, they should of course make sure the homeowner is aware of the situation and they should have a plan to get it fixed. So now let's talk about potential electrical issues. Well, obviously the concern is if there are wires inside the wall that during the drilling process, any of those wires get nicked or even tangled in that drilling. Now, this is a very rare occurrence. Typically, wiring is going to be connected or right next to your studs inside your walls, but there are times that there's not. There are floating wires throughout houses all over the place, and unfortunately, you don't know what's going on inside the wall until you start drilling into it. So this is a very rare thing, or at least it should be, but it is a possibility. And again, you should have a plan in place as a contractor to handle this situation if it comes up. If you're a fan of contractors being transparent like we are today, please like this video and subscribe to the channel. So now let's touch on vibrations. You gotta remember, again, we are drilling into exterior walls. Of course, this process will create a lot of vibrations, especially if you're working with a brick house. That causes the most vibrations. Now, typically, this is no problem at all. However, if you do have, you know, some loose knickknacks or pictures hanging on your walls, those exterior walls, it may be a good idea to just take those down. This should be something that your installer or even your project manager goes over with you beforehand, but be conscious of this, especially if you have a brick home and you're putting injection foam in, those walls will vibrate and there is a chance that some loose things could get knocked off. So as you can see, there are some rare but still potential issues when you're doing an injection foam install. As I said, any contractor that's worth their salt should be aware of these, should have experience handling it, and they should have a plan in place if any of these occur. To learn more about our install process, please go to our website, retrofoam.com. We have all kinds of articles and guides just for you. This is the Professor of Foam reminding you that building is a science.